Hello, everyone. My name is Besra Gansop, and we're so excited that you're going to be applying for the Harvard Summer School. This video is going to walk through our application and show you steps from beginning to end on how to successfully apply to the Harvard Summer School. Just to note, the profile and application should be created and completed by the student and not the parent, counselor, or anyone else. To apply, your first step is going to be to create a DCE key. If you've applied or have attended the summer school before, you will have a DCE key. Make sure to use those same credentials. As you create your DCE key, check all biographical information before submitting. Any inaccuracy will require additional paperwork to make corrections. Once you create a DCE key, you'll receive this particular page that will require you to go to your email to verify, which will look something like this. You'll go ahead and confirm my email address, log back on, and arrive at the Harvard Summer School online application. You'll go ahead and proceed with starting an application and start an application under Programs for High School Students. Before you start the application, read the description of each program available to you through the Harvard Summer School. The secondary school program, you have two programs. You have the four-week program, residential program, where you take a four-credit course, or a seven-week four-credit program where the participants can live on campus, commute, or take the course online. The students in seven-week residential program must take 8 credits in total, 2 4-credit courses or 1 8-credit course. Students in the 7-week online and commuting programs can take either 4 or 8 credits in total. Please note, all students on an I-20 must enroll in 8 on-campus credits. We also have the Harvard Pre-College Program, a non-credit 2-week residential program where you can take a college-level course and engage in various co-curricular activities. Please read the program in detail, including graduation and age requirements. You have to be 16 by the first day of the summer school and not turn 19 before July 31st. The Harvard Summer School has strict requirements for all applicants must satisfy to be eligible for admissions. No exceptions are made. Once you thoroughly read through the new application detail, you'll select the program you'll be applying to. End the term. For this demonstration, I'll be selecting the 7-week program, college credit, and the term says QA test term, but when applying, should read summer of 2025. You can then start the application. When you start your application, you'll see a list of items you'll have to complete located here. I've gone through and filled out some items to help speed this demonstration, but yours will start completely transparent, similar to this, indicated that you haven't started this section. The other colors, half yellow, means you've begun the section, and solid green indicates that you've successfully completed that section. The first portion of this application is contact information. Majority of this information, name, date of birth, and mobile, will populate from DCE key you've completed. Look through the information and make sure it's correct. Please reach out to the summer school if you come across any incorrect information. I went through and completed it earlier, so we're done. We're going to go ahead and save and continue. This next section continues with demographic information. Citizenship will determine whether you're eligible for financial aid, which is need-based here at the summer school. It's only available to US citizens or permanent residents. If you select international, you'll see that financial aid ineligibility will already be automatically indicated. For the sake of this demonstration, I will go ahead and press US citizen. So I can walk you through the financial aid application later. All right, and this is all for the most part completed. For native language, if you press a native language other than English, example, I'll go ahead and type in Tigrinya as my native language. If you go to the sidebar, you'll see that an English proficiency will have to be uploaded. You'll have to submit either a TOEFL, an IELTS, or Duolingo academic score. For now, I'll select Tigrinya so we can go ahead and upload that later on during the application. We'll go ahead and press save and continue. This next section is participation status. This question will not show up if you're applying for the 4-week or 2-week program because they're residential. For the 7-week program, you have the option for residential, online, or commuter. If you are a permanent resident that's listed within a reasonable commuting distance from Harvard, such as Massachusetts, Maine, New Hampshire, Rhode Island, Connecticut, Vermont, or even possibly New York, then you can apply as a commute from home student, which is this option right here. If your permanent residence is listed as anywhere outside of those states, you should apply as commute from relatives home. Commute from relatives, students will be asked to submit additional forms from their parent and guardian and their prospective host in the application. So, for example, if I do commute from residence, you'll see there is a parent off-campus living request and a host off-campus living request that will have to be submitted. For this demonstration, I will go ahead and be a resident, meaning live in the residential dorms on campus. Go ahead and press save and continue. This next section is parent or legal guardian contact information. The person you note will receive media release form to fill out on your behalf. Be sure to communicate with the individual you noted to make sure they check their email and complete the form. Make sure their email address and their phone numbers are different and represent the parent and guardian's information and not the student's. Okay, I had already went through and completed that. I'm gonna go ahead and press save and continue. So this next is education background. If you've applied to the summer school in previous years, you can mark yes. It will follow up by asking you if you've attended after being accepted. For this demonstration, I'll go ahead and mark no for attending the summer school and no ever being enrolled in the Harvard Extension School course. If you are first in your family to attend college or university, you'll select yes here, which I'll go ahead and do. Now go ahead and press save and continue. For this next section, you'll select the year you're graduating high school from. The options provided. So we have 2025 all the way to 2027. Only the ones eligible to apply will show up and pre-populate. When entering your school's name, make sure you type the complete name. If your school doesn't show up, you can go ahead and simply type in unknown. You'll then go ahead and attach your academic transcript here. Grades should reflect everything from ninth grade through the current term. If your current grades are not reflected in your transcript, please attach a progress report of your current term. I'm going to go ahead and upload my transcript. All right, we're going to go ahead and save and continue. If you're affiliated with one of these organizations listed above, you'll note yes here. It will then follow up where you'll go ahead and select your partnership and an organization application fee code, which they'll provide for you. If this is new to you and you haven't necessarily heard about this, the answer is probably simply a no. I'm gonna go ahead and save and continue. Because we selected our native language that was not English above, this is where you'll attach your TOEFL, IELTS, academic, or Duolingo English test scores. Make sure your attachment is clearly visible and provides your complete results. I'm gonna go ahead and upload my TOEFL. save and continue. So this next section is the counselor request form. Reach out to your guidance counselor prior to sending out the form so they know they'll be receiving an email to fill out as part of your application. This allows them to prepare accordingly. For this section, you'll type in your counselor, dean, or advisor's first name, last name, and email address. As noted here, once you save the information, the individual you noted above will receive the form to complete. If you've incorrectly typed their name or email address, you can always log back onto your portal and edit the information, which I'll show you later in the application. You'll have the visibility in the application portal of the status of the counsel request form and if it's been updated, so you can follow up with your counselor as needed. I've already typed in Greg Davis and his email address, and we'll go ahead, save, and continue. The next five sections are essays. This is the portion where you get to share a little about who you are. All the essays are pretty straightforward, but I do want to take the opportunity to discuss the first essay. We want to know what you're interested in studying, enrolling in, and why. You can browse through last year's catalog, located right here, or this year, depending on when you're applying as a reference. As noted, the course you write about does not constitute course registration. The last essay, essay number five, which is right here, provides applicants who have incurred any serious or repeated disciplinary action to explain below. If this does not apply to you, as noted in the application, simply state no, which I've already done. Essays apart from essay question five should be between 250 and 350 words. Make sure you proofread your essays carefully. Typing your essays on a Word document and copying and pasting it into the application is good practice. Make sure you're moving your response into the right section and nothing gets cut off. Remember to cite any sources that you use in the essay. This next section, optional additional information, provides you an opportunity to provide any insight you think might be beneficial for the admissions committee to know. This could be grades that don't accurately reflect your potential, a personal situation that may have impacted your academic progress, etc. This isn't necessary, but available for any applicant that needs space to address anything regarding their application. For this, I'll go ahead and type in no. If you wish to apply for financial aid, this is a section where you do so. As a reminder, financial aid is need-based and only available for U.S. citizens or permanent residents. These are confidential, meaning that the financial aid and the admissions applications are reviewed separately and don't impact one another. If you think you'll be eligible for financial aid scholarship, simply go to a drop-down and press yes, I wish to apply. Otherwise, press no. If you press yes, it's important to complete the financial aid scholarship portion before submitting your application. Additionally, do not send tax returns or other confidential or sensitive information via email. There are approximately 9 questions associated with the financial aid scholarship that requires household information, income information, asset information, and additional information. Some of this information will come directly from the tax return. This is a key section where it's highly suggested you tap in your parent or guardian to assist. If you have any questions regarding the financial aid portion of your application, you can send an email to sspfinancialaid@summer.harvard.edu for the 4 and 7 week program, or precollegefinancialaid@summer.harvard.edu for the 2 week program. For this demonstration, now that you have the opportunity to take a look, I will go ahead and press no, I do not wish to apply. I'm going to go ahead, save, and continue. This next section is rules and regulation form. As the applicant, it is important that you read this section carefully and acknowledge that you agree and understand the rules and regulations set forth by the Harvard Summer School. You will then read the student recording authorization and media release form and add your parent and legal guardian's name and address. So once you press yes, the student recording authorization will automatically pop up where you'll go ahead and type in their name and then press save and continue. Finally, there's the application agreement. If you're interested in program offerings, updates, and content, go ahead, scroll down yes to subscribe. After you've read the rights and responsibility as the applicant, you'll scroll down and acknowledge by selecting yes, save and review application. Alrighty. So go through and carefully review all the information, making sure that it's accurate and complete. Once you're confident that everything looks good, feel free to submit your application on your right. It will then take you to the final page to verify and submit. Type in my name. Verify and submit. You'll then proceed to paying the application fee online by entering your credit card information. Once you complete all of this, you can go ahead and just press continue, and that'll automatically complete your application. Now that the application and the payment has been processed, application is now officially submitted. This is the online application portal where you'll have access to your checklist to see what's done and what has yet to be completed. Remember to follow up with individuals as needed to ensure your application is complete by the application deadline. It's important that you check your application portal regularly, as that is where the admissions committee notifies you of any missing or incomplete material. So I still have the college counselor report that has not been submitted, and the parent guardian still hasn't completed the form that was sent. Your application is not considered complete and will not be reviewed until all required materials are submitted. That's an important message to remember. If you have any other questions, please reach out. We can't wait to welcome you this upcoming summer. Best wishes and good luck.